Hi everyone and welcome back to the 26th episode of Praticamente Inglese. Ciao a tutti e bentornati al 26esimo episodio di Praticamente Inglese. Today I would like to talk about networking events. Vorrei parlarvi dei cosiddetti networking events, momenti di aggregazione in contesto di business. Potrebbe essere un aperitivo di lavoro, un party aziendale, un momento, diciamo, di networking durante una fiera di settore, un exhibition, ok? Sarebbe la fiera, eccetera, eccetera. As always, I'm trying to speak a little bit more in English at the very first part of the episode, and then we're going to talk in Italian later on to see maybe to review a few terms that we have used during the episode. Come ultimamente sto facendo, parlerò molto più in inglese nella prima parte, visto che mi è stato richiesto, e devo dire che sta avendo, diciamo, approvazione questa cosa, e poi al termine di tutta la prima parte in inglese parlerò in italiano per andare a discutere magari alcuni termini o cose andiamo ad approfondire quello che ho detto in inglese. Ok? So, let's get started. What is a networking event? Okay, so as you know, I lived in London for many years and I've attended quite a few of those events in my career, in my sales career. The goal of a networking event is to, how can I say, it's to encourage people to engage, to connect each other. So they can meet in a, maybe during an exhibition, is a business party, usually is in a business environment. So in order to create business opportunities and leads, okay? So you can find at this event, for example, the director of a company, the marketing manager of, I don't know, an agency, the sales manager of a hotel, the PR of a, I don't know, conference venue. Okay, so different roles from different companies. They can maybe do business together because someone is selling something that the other one is maybe needed. Okay, so I can tell you about my experience during those events. Usually, those events are organized in a hotel, in a venue, maybe during a conference or an exhibition, with drinks and canapés. Okay, so drinks and canapés. Maybe at some point there's a small presentation from the organizers, or from the host of the event. Okay, so you have different setups, different layouts of networking events. That could be, I don't know, speed dating, so you have maybe 10 minutes to talk each other, so you quickly can meet a lot of people in a short period of time. And that could be maybe a one-to-one, or round tables, or it could be a lounge with some music. There are different kind of setups of those networking events. Usually at the entrance, you will get your badge, so with your name on it, your company written on it. So it's much easier to recognize other people and maybe your target, your the person you want to speak with, okay? So you're looking for a potential client. So if you, I don't know, represent an hotel in Milan, you are looking for companies that have their office based in Milan. So you can maybe offer a great accommodation to their colleagues, the people working for that company, okay? So that's the reason why you try to select the people you want to speak with. There is a lot of people giving their business cards to others. So you give your business cards to the people you're speaking with. So when they come back in the office, they will add the contact details in their database or in their CRM, okay? So you for example, get 10 business cards, and then you come back in the office the day after, and then you put it in your system. And you maybe write a note, okay, this guy is the director of this company, this could be interested in this and that, I have to maybe send him an email, or maybe yesterday we were talking and I promised him to send him something, so I will have to do this, and maybe this could be tomorrow a new client, okay? So this could be a lead and then an opportunity for the business I represent. So during those networking events, of course, you don't have to speak. How can I say? You usually start the conversation like, "Hey, nice to meet you. My name is Mattia. How are you? Hey, how did you hear about this event? I've been invited by the owner of this company, or I've been invited by the organizer of the event. Ah, nice." Or maybe other, let's say, they usually call it like small talk. So very common sentences, very common phrases that you say during when you meet with someone else. So, hey, beautiful day outside, isn't it? Yeah, definitely. I can't wait to, I can't wait for a nice walk later on, to do a nice walk later on when I come back to the office or when I come back home. Hey, how was your week? I'm working hard on a project, but you know, thanks God, I'm almost at the end of it. Ah, nice. What about you? Do you have any plans for the weekend? And you can say, yes, yeah, I'm planning to go, I don't know, skiing with my family in Roccaraso. Okay, it's not possible, unfortunately, in this moment, in this tough moment. But maybe next year in 2021, we'll get back on track. Everybody will be able to, you know, come back to a normal, a regular life. So you have great plans for the weekend. You could travel and you can go around. So let's hope this will be possible. Or maybe, you know, for example, if you're talking with another person, you can say, did you see the match last night? I'm AC Milan fan. What about you? Don't talk about, you know, sport too much, you know, as a fan during those events. You shouldn't be speaking about, you know, religion, political issues or those kind of thing, because you're always trying with the other person to, you know, talk a little bit more lightly, okay? You don't go too deep in this kind of controversial or maybe arguments, you know what I mean? So I wouldn't talk about that, but maybe you can say, hey, did you see the match yesterday, last night, about, I don't know, the national team? That could be, you know, something nice. Everyone, of course, they are fan of the national team. So you can maybe talk about that. Or maybe you can say, what do you do? I look after the marketing department at ABC company. We are creating a new software to help companies to find the right candidate on the internet, you know, and we do this and we do that. That's it mainly, you know. And then you say, of course, it was great talking to you. Here is my business card. Let's stay in touch. Okay, so you give your business card. So the other person will give you his or her business card, and so you will get in touch later on with an email, maybe with a call later on. Who knows? Okay, so that's it, more or less, about networking events. So let's talk in Italian a little bit, and let's see if we need to touch some points in what I just said about, you know, the networking events. Ok, quindi ho cercato di parlarvi un pochino di quello che è un networking event, quindi un momento in cui ci si incontra in un contesto di business. Potrebbero esserci persone, no, di una determinata società, compagnia, che potrebbero essere interessati a parlare con quell'altra compagnia, perché potrebbe essere un probabile prospetto per poter vendere domani il proprio servizio, il proprio prodotto, e quindi ci si incontra in maniera un po' più informale, magari con un drink in mano. No? Drinks and canapés, che non sarebbe altro che un cocktail, potrebbe essere un bicchiere di prosecco o perché no di champagne se l'evento è molto, diciamo, molto molto in, e in canapés, che non è altro che, insomma, tartine, o comunque in Italia sarebbero, no, un po' di pizza, un po' di cose da mangiare, di stuzzichini, ecco, mettiamola così. E quindi durante questi eventi si cerca di, come dire, far sì che si possa incontrare domande e offerta in un contesto informale. Può avvenire during an exhibition, quindi durante una fiera vera e propria, could be a corporate party, quindi una festa, diciamo, aziendale, maybe could be, I don't know, usually in a hotel, in a venue, in a conference venue. E quindi praticamente io cerco di andare a incontrare queste persone, conoscerci meglio, e automaticamente ci sono delle frasi di circostanza. Hey, nice to meet you, how's it going? Beautiful day outside, isn't it? Quindi bellissimo giornata fuori, non è così? Confermi? Oh, sì, yes, definitely, can't wait for a walk, to do a nice walk later on, non vedo l'ora di farmi una bella passeggiata più tardi. Coming back, you know, to my home, coming back to my office, nel ritornare nel mio ufficio, nel ritornare a casa. Did you hear about this? Or hai sentito di questo? Did you see the match last night? Hai visto il match la scorsa notte? Io vi spiegavo prima che cerco di non parlare mai, ma in generale questa è una regola non scritta, ma abbastanza comune, di politica, di religione, magari di sport, lì dove lo sport è divisivo, no? Perché magari uno tifa per il Milan, uno per la Juve, allora non ci si ritrova subito. Però magari potrebbe essere: did you see the match last night? Magari il match era della nazionale, che invece è un po' più, come dire, ci mette tutti sotto lo stesso cappello. What do you do? Tu puoi spiegare qual è il tuo ruolo all'interno della compagnia, cosa fa la tua compagnia. Ho buttato un esempio: we are creating a new software to help companies to find the right candidate on the internet. Quindi creiamo un software che aiuta le compagnie, le società, a cercare il miglior candidato su internet. E poi la cosa più importante è: here's my business card, let's stay in touch. Quindi il fatto di porgere la propria business card e, come dire, sperare che poi ci si possa risentire sia tramite email sia tramite telefono per, come dire, costruire una relazione che poi magari un domani possa portare a del business vero e proprio, quindi a chiudere un deal, a avere la firma su un contratto di un servizio, un prodotto che si vende, insomma, che si rappresenta. So guys, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the podcast. As you know, I am looking to do something more for the new year. Quindi, come sapete, sto cercando di fare qualcosa di nuovo per il nuovo anno. L'idea è quella di creare una vera e propria community intorno a questo podcast e offrire qualcosina in più a chi veramente è interessato, in maniera un po' più costante, ad avere, come dire, i tools, le informazioni e la pratica per, come dire, poter sempre di più migliorarsi e parlare di più in inglese, ok? Quindi di potervi esprimervi meglio. E le cose arriveranno, vi darò tutte le maggiori informazioni. Sto cercando di trovare il modo migliore per far sì che sia subito un qualcosa, diciamo, di carino, di aggregativo per tutti coloro che volessero seguirmi. E that's it for today. Hope you will have a great week ahead. And I'll see you in the next episode. Bye bye.
Segui i podcast di Voice sulla tua app di podcast preferita. E se sei un utente Prime, ascoltalo senza pubblicità su Amazon Music.